Yeah, this was back in the Mesozoic. The Mesmesrozoic, to be specific. In those days, the cats were not cats. They were dinosaurs. Black, brown, beige, and albino dinos. Back then, the subtropical scene was hot, and the music was too, because, like the ubiquitous and uninhibited volcanoes, all of those dinos could blow. And what they blew was antique bebop on a spiky array of archaic cornets, ancient basses, antediluvian tubas, proto-trombones, and pre-lapsarian saxophones. Unfortunately, no recordings of any Saurian sessions have been found, except for a few fossil records, all of which have a tendency to skip on the tectonic turntable. But more on that later. Anyway, one bright, sunny day in the Mesozoic, Archie Bird Archaeopteryx was on his way to a gig at Club Moss. Yeah, you see, Archie blew pretty cool for a hot-blooded creature. His axe was paleo-soprano sax, and though his ideas were a bit primitive, his chops were omnivorous, his rhythm sizzled, and his technique was constantly evolving. On the afternoon in question, he was perching in with Plates Delaney, the leader of an all-stegosaurus quartet, and he was hustling to the club to try to catch a bite before the gig. Now, it must be noted that at Club Moss, you were just as likely to be a bite as to catch one. The place was run by carnivorous mobsters, reptilian racketeers, gargantuan goodfellas who worked for the biggest lizard in the district, Aloysius Alleyboy Allosaurus. Darwin Help, the tipsy Diplodocus or Blotto Iguanodont who accidentally gronked into one of these guys, or for that matter, the paleo-soprano player who blew out of tune. Still, the pay was good, the house put out free fronds for the band, and even if musicians were occasionally on the menu, hey, it was better than working the tar pits. So Archie was on his way to play with Plates when, at the corner of 10th and Triassic, he spied an evangelical triceratops, a member of the cult known as Born Again Hornigans, dressed in sackcloth and volcanic ashes and carrying a placard in its unspeakable beak which read, "Dinos repent, the comet is coming." It was easy to dismiss out of claw such fanaticism, but something about the creature's demeanor touched a raw tooth in Archie. He thought, they've been saying this comet's been coming for years, but this time, what if they're right? Suppose the ferns burn up. Suppose the flowering cycads die. Suppose the dust shuts out the sun. Suppose the whole sick scene is 86th. What's gonna happen to the music? We don't have any recording technology. How are the creatures who follow us gonna know the stuff we blow? Yeah, these were Archie's moody ruminations as he rounded the reedy corner and stepped through the immense and densely foliated door of Club Moss. Plates Delaney and the rhythm section were just sitting up, and the usual crowd of hepasaurs and hippasaurs was letting it rip, scoffing fronds, drinking that ginkgo wine, smoking them horsetail spliffs, and thundering pleasantries. Hey, Plates, how's it banging?
Like the crank of an ankylosaurus, baby.
Delaney smiled. Archie took his axe out and started to warm up. Since it was already 110 in the shade, he didn't have to go far. So Plates and Archie and the quartet leapt into the first set, playing such respectable, yet even by then, archaic standards as "How Low the Moon," "I'm in the Mud for Love," "Strangers in the Ammonite," "Volcanic Ash Gets in Your Eyes," and the Chattanooga "Choo-choo, chomp-chomp, masticate, masticate, gulp, gulp." The band was just beginning to cook, so Plates decided to call one of Archie's originals, O.U. Eurypterid U.
O.U. Eurypterid U.
Suddenly, there was an uproar at the door, a slither of activity among the management, and a collective hiss of Cretaceous amazement as the boss himself, Aloysius Alleyboy Allosaurus, entered the club with his entourage of duckbill bimbos, armored bookkeepers, and squamous bodyguards. The latter wasted no time disabusing a party of 10 pterodactyls from out of town of a table at the foot of the stage and there ensconcing Alley Boy, who rarely deigned to make the scene, but was the scene whenever he did. Plates had taken 5 when the commotion kicked in, but Alley Boy, king of the carnivorous party animals, was there to wax happy.
Hey, Delaney!
He seismically rumbled,
"Play Melancholy Megalosaurus."
Inwardly wincing, Plates grinned at the band and was ready to count it off, a 1 and a 2 and a... But Archie demurred.
"No way, Plates. I'm not gonna play that Mickey Marsupial shit."
For what seemed a geologic epic, everything rose. The only sounds in the club were the nervous flexing of hyperextendable second toes, the wavy flutter of wattles and head combs, and the clucking of the duckbills. Then, fixing the paleo soprano player with his cold, predaceous eyes, Alley Boy hissed,
"What did you say, amphibian fucker?"
Archie didn't speak. Instead, he put his mouthpiece to his beak, jumped into the head of Brontosaurus Bop, segued into the bridge of an eon in Tunisia, tossed in a derisive riff or two of them there spines, and dodging a sudden flurry of sickle claws, literally flew from the stage.
"Get that feather brain!"
yelled Alley Boy to his massive minions, but Archie was out the door, down the street, one beat ahead of the colossal posse, which, as it tumbled out of the club, bowled over the evangelical triceratops who was proselytizing for the comet at the door. On flew Archie, fluttering into the ferny twilight, feeling himself to be at the brink of extinction and rueful as he ran, that now he'd never have the chance to transmit the music to who or what was next in line in the phylogenetic medley of existence. Finally, he reached the corner of calcium and carbonate, a limestone cul-de-sac.
"This is it," Archie panted. "I have arrived at the end of the set. I will now take 5 forever."
Behind him, the mean behemoths moved in for the kill, when suddenly, they were reeling and rolling on the ground. The earth shook. The sky was lit by a million fires. The mountains bowed, and the biggest wind of unrecorded prehistory carried the booming doom across Pangaea. Right on random schedule, the comet had struck, and Archie, at the moment of truth, took out his Archaeopteryx axe and blew his proto-avian soul into limestone.
Thank you.
Yeah, the Mesozoic flamed out about 63 million years ago last Friday. But the antique bebop of Archie Bird Archaeopteryx, which leapt around and crept around and even slept around in slithering riverbeds, continues to be kept around to grace the place and green the scene. You can still hear bits and pieces of Archie's limestone LP in the hip chitter of the chickadee, the groovy gobble of the turkey, the cool cackle of the grackle, the all-reet tweet of the tufted tit, even in the rap of the sapsucker and the yakety-yak of parrots. In fact, just the other day, I heard a minor bird say to an African gray,
"Oh, give me four, dinosaur!"